So what's up YouTube, welcome to my channel Complete Tech Review and welcome to another walk around shoot of the Bajaj Pulsar 150 twin disc. So this is the most muscular and the most stylish looking 150cc Pulsar that you can buy currently. And the reason why I say it's muscular is because of the fatter front suspension, the bold and the muscular fuel tank and the fatter tires. So this only aids to the overall styling and makes the bike more muscular and more menacing to look at. The Pulsar twin disc is in the BS6 motor and this one comes with the 5-speed gearing. The BS6 motor is 149.50cc and this one delivers a maximum power of around 14 PS at 8500 RPM. And this one delivers around torque which is 13.25 Nm at 8500 RPM. So the Pulsar twin disc is the only vehicle which comes with a split handlebar and this only aids to the overall styling. The mirror quality is also really good. The switchgear quality is a backlit and as I said it gets dual horns and hence the horn is pretty loud. This is having a lot of good features and with an ex-showroom price of 1,02,000 or 1,03,000, this is one of the most sportiest Pulsar that you can buy. And right now let's check out the exhaust note, which is also, you know, on the throatier and bassier side. Instrumentation console is a part analog and a digital unit which gets all the telltale signs. You have the ABS indicator, the neutral, the high beam, the turn indicator, and also as I mentioned it gets the side stand indicator. So this indicates that it is a BS6 motor and comes with fuel injection. The other highlight of the vehicle is on the braking side. This gets the front ABS and the front is a 280mm disc whereas the rear is a 230mm unit. It comes with single channel ABS which is a plus sign. The engine is a fuel injected engine and you can see the BS6 canister which is integrated into the exhaust pipe. The BS6 Pulsar 150 twin disc comes with twin horns which is also a nice touch and also a rarity to see in the 150cc segment. As I said, it comes with a 5-speed gearbox and it is a slick and a precise gearbox. The rear disc comes with the speed sensing sensor. On the indicators, these are the flexible type unit and this is a good thought because once when the bike falls, it ensures that the indicators are not getting broken. The chain is an exposed unit and it is only aids from the styling point of view. It also gets the side stand indicator and the gearing you can see is one down and all up. The neutral is in the center. It comes with a twin spark DDSI engine and this is an age old reliable engine and has a legacy of more than 10 plus years. The fuel tank is again a chunky unit and you can see this actually reminds us about the Pulsar and the old Pulsar, and it comes with 15 liters of fuel tank and with a mileage claims of around 50 to 55 kilometers per liter, it has a good tank range. The seating is a split seat unit and the seat quality looks good and it also is a plush and a comfortable seat. I also like the tank slip guard which is given and also the front rank cowl and the stickering behind it. The front suspension is the fatter 37mm front fork and this only aids to the overall muscularity of the bike. And the rear comes with the adjustable Nitroc suspension. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do so, please like and subscribe to my channel. This is Kevin signing off and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.